to the ice. Ray Emery is challenging Holtby. Holtby's saying, no, I don't think I want to go. And the referee's going to try to keep them separated. And he won't be able to do that as away they go. Emery with the right hand's free, and he's hammering away on Holtby. Capitals not coming to his aid at this point as Emery is just having his way with Holtby.
While this has been going on, there's been a lot of talk going back and forth, and it's anything but friendly.
Oh, we've got another one going now as LeCavalier is trading with Alexi, and now Shen going at it as well with Urbom, and it's a line brawl for sure. Just about everybody tangled up right here.
But hey, don't leave anything on the ice. Go home and go understand.
I can't tell, but reaches back. And that is whistled down, and nobody is happy now. It's in came Gagne with a late poke. And look out as Talbot is into it, and he wants a piece of somebody back there.
And Gagne's coming back at Giordano, and now Giordano's coming up too. This thing blew over in a hurry.
And Smith is coming up to center ice as this thing comes unglued.
And Bear in the high slot here fighting, looks like with Matthew Tkachuk.
It's Tkachuk and Bear, and they are trading them. Bear comes over the top of the right. Tkachuk comes back. And now Talbot and Mike Smith are going to go as center ice. Talbot and Smith, who've been on both sides of this battle of Alberta. This is unbelievable.
Wow. Both guys played for the other team, respectively, the year before in the battle of Alberta. They're going against each other. And Mike Smith came right to center. Talbot's
Bernier. Bernier's going after Miller. Here they're going.
Bernier, wow. And Miller. Bernier and Miller now jostling along. The last time a Leaf goalie was involved in something like this was Felix Potvin. Miller and Bernier. Well, the backup goalies had better get ready. And Bernier throwing some punches.
I've never seen Miller in a fight before, and I've...
Well, he got run over a couple of times. Now Bernier's got an arm free without the big goalie pad on, and Miller's in a little trouble here.
Ooh. He's giving it to him.
A couple of right hands. The linesmen aren't breaking this up either.
Are you watching, Felix?
And Scott is over on the other side, and David Clarkson is there.
Now look at Kessel now. He spears him. Kessel came back and speared Scott.
Well, he gave him a tap with the stick for sure.
Well, he wants him. Look, they're not going to let him get to him.
Now it's way out of control, and Johnson's in his second fight in a week. And Haley is trying to do to him what Johnson did to Rick DiPietro. I think Talbot's in there also.
Look, they're motioning at the benches because they're worried because it's an un. But if you look, as Tangredi's down here. He got. So Johnson say, okay, come on, you want to go? And you watch, Goddard's going to come right off the bench. And he just grabs on, and now it's a 2-on-1. That's supposed to happen when you have the puck, not when there's a fight going on, Howie.
Along with Bill Bird. This is Langdon and Chara dancing out near the Islanders' blue line. Langdon went at it earlier with Ogic. He fought Ken Belange of the Islanders twice earlier this season. Chara trying to get his arms free. And now this is Langdon and Bird.
The big fella,
Bill Bird.
I don't know if the big fella any fighting lessons or not, but if I was him, I would get in and use my height and weight because I don't think he's throwing them too often. And right now, he better just cover up because Langdon is a big, tough boy.
And here, oh, Stock. DJ Stock and Tchaikovsky.
And I think maybe Tchaikovsky bit off a little more than he could chew with DJ Stock because he throws them pretty good. And I don't think Tchaikovsky is a noted fighter.
No. And now the goaltender, Salo, comes over. Here comes Cloutier.
Kenny, we said old-time hockey lives. Well, here it is.
Dan Cloutier has been known to get into fights in the minor leagues. It happened earlier this year with the Hartford Wolfpack. Really throwing them at Salo.
Well, here's another game misconduct because the jersey is off. And Krejci is quitting a job. But right now, somebody's got to get loose and put a stop. I don't care if it's a lineman, a referee, or whoever. But when a guy is down and out, okay, Krejci is smart enough to back off, leave it alone, and away he goes.
And now Krejci challenging the Islanders' bench. Things have gotten out of control here on Long Island.
Big Chera is still moving around. Langdon still wants a piece of Chera. Chera went over to help one of his teammates. Langdon come back in behind.
By Price, he's not in a position to control that rebound, and Lucic buries it.
Marchand unloads. Now we got a Donnybrook going. Price is out of his goal. Everybody's paired off. Chara wants a piece of Pacioretty, who's tied up with Camper. Chara says, you're mine, buddy. I remember the push in OT. Numbers taken, memories long, nastiness aplenty. 8 goals on the board, and we're barely past the halfway mark of this game.
Now, Pacioretty, he saw both Chara and Camper, and you know where he was going. He was going for Camper. He wanted nothing to do with the big fella. Now we got Thomas joining the fray.
Thomas is challenging Price. He's saying, you want to go fuck? Price just threw down the helmet. Here we go. Price goes for the right. Thomas goes for the takedown. I guess goalies don't have fight straps, huh?
Andre Fleury.
And Fleury
had a little exchange with each other.
Yeah, Fleury gave him a little shrug. If you want to come down, you're welcome.
And Kudai getting pointed back into the net for Francois Saint-Laurent.
Yep. Flower still talking about 150 feet.
And Kudai's got his hands up. He's here to go.